A new study out of the United Kingdom has found that the chemicals in vaping fluid are causing a cascade of problems in the human body. And those fruity flavors that young people seem to love, well, they're on the market and they have potential to cause diseases, Farron, that we don't even know the names of the diseases. I mean, that's what struck me. They said this is happening so fast, we can't even keep up with the way that these chemicals are morphing. We're seeing chemicals we've never seen coming from a vaping pen. Pick it up.
Yeah, because what's happening is, well, first of all, you've got at least they've identified 180 chemicals in some of the most popular flavors of these vaping fluids. But these researchers say, listen, we can only look at necessarily the individual chemicals. What we can't look at and understand yet, because it hasn't been long enough, is what happens when you superheat these chemicals
synergistically
together. Yeah. So we've got chemical reactions taking place inside your vape in a matter of nanoseconds that then goes into your lungs. And again, these things have not been around long enough for us to have any kind of long-term studies. So what these researchers in the UK did, which is actually quite brilliant, is they ran it through artificial intelligence. Yeah. They said, simulate these chemical reactions inside a human body over a period of 5 years, 10 years. And basically this AI-generated body is so filled with diseases, like you said,
they don't know what they are. They don't even know what the diseases are. Neurological, cardiac, pulmonary. They're seeing variations of chemicals they've never even seen before. While these cats are saying, well, I don't smoke anymore. Right. By God, I got off of tobacco. Our law firm brought the first tobacco cases in America. Believe me, I know how bad tobacco is. But at the same time, you have, I call them these new pioneers. They're pioneers of new diseases. They're pioneers of new chemicals. That's what this guy is right here as he smokes his vape. He's a pioneer. He's pioneering new diseases that we won't see for 10 or 15 years. New chemicals. Wow, we got a new chemical out there. Wonder what we're going to do with it. It's just, what is it? Is it 40,000 different flavors, okay? Yeah. And each flavor, according to this, has potential to create diseases we've never even seen before, right?
Right. And each of those 40,000 different flavors means 40,000 different chemical combinations. And if you're using, well, today I'm a grape flavor, tomorrow I'm a cherry flavor, now suddenly you've got different chemicals now interacting with the other. It's insanity. You're turning your body into this little, you know, disgusting laboratory, and you don't even know. And they have the audacity to tell us it's safe, is what the vapors do.
Oh, yeah, we're going to get
the
most rabid, crazy. And I love it. You know,
it's
hilarious. They are so friggin' crazy. Well, it got me. I stopped smoking. Go back to friggin' smoking. You're safer. You know, if you follow this story. And, you know, the truth is the industry, of course, is reaching out to kids. Ollie Ollie Orange, Goofy Grape, Susie Strawberry. Those are kind of the flavor names. I don't know if those are exactly the names, but that's what they do.
Yeah.
They name it these cutesy little names. And, oh, wow, this tastes like grape. This can't be bad for me. Well, thank you. You're a new pioneer. You are engineering new diseases that we haven't seen, and we'll see them in the next 10 or 15 years. I guess that's the only congratulations you can give these cats, because that's exactly what's happening.
Yeah, and look, my biggest issue with these folks that do this is, listen, if you want to do it, okay? That is your prerogative 100%.
Yeah, of course.
But stop fooling yourself into thinking that this is safe, that, oh, well, there's no studies that show it's going to cause diseases, because there's no time yet. I mean, these things have been around for maybe 14 or 15 years. You know, from their early incarnation of what was called the e-cigarettes at the time. But stop pretending that, oh, well, since no long-term studies exist, obviously it's fine. It hasn't been a long round enough for there to be long-term studies.
I mean, anybody with a brain can analyze that. You don't need AI to tell you that. But AI is saying, well, by God, we're seeing diseases. We're projecting diseases we don't even have names for. We're projecting chemicals that we don't even know what to call them.
Well, it's going to end up being Goofy Grape Syndrome. And,
exactly. Vice President Harris recently received endorsements for some of the worst human beings on the earth. the worst war criminals on the earth, and she seems really proud of that. It's a list that includes Dick Cheney and Alberto Gonzalez. The campaign is thrilled about the endorsement of these war whores that seem to be the average Democrat nowadays when you look at what the party's become. Used to be the Republicans. I still think they are, don't get me wrong. Republicans on this issue, they're the same war pimps that we see with the Democrats. But the Democrats are trying to hide behind, no, we're different. You know, we're different. I mean, I go back to John Kerry, when John Kerry talked about the what's happening with the military-industrial complex, creating a crisis of historical proportions, because he was concerned that the Democrats were embracing the war machine. John Kerry. Now, he said that while he was running.
20 years ago.
And it's just gotten worse. And now, like I said, now we have Liz Cheney. Dick Cheney is our hero for the Democratic Party. The Democratic Party is endorsed by 132 war whores, neocon war whores. And the Democrats, oh, this is wonderful. Well, you know why? Because the money's good.
Right.
The money's good. All of these people are part of the weapons industry. They are the modern Dr. Strangelove. That's what's going on here. And the Democrats seem to embrace it. I used to look at this, and on front of this missile would be a Republican sign, you know? It would not be that. It would be an elephant. Wouldn't be a donkey.
Yeah, and I think you're absolutely right about that. I think with the shift of these, you know, war criminals, I mean, Dick Cheney, Alberto Gonzalez, he's the guy that wrote the torture memos.
Right.
He should be in The Hague, right, not out here endorsing candidates office.
Right.
And these are people that when we started Ring of Fire here, we were trashing these people every week for the damage they were causing across the planet.
Republicans, this is what we did for years. We talked about Alberto Gonzalez needs to be perp walked. Dick Cheney killed hundreds of thousands of people based on the lie of weapons mass destruction. And then his daughter, Liz, who is now the favorite on cabal cable television, the talking head, she's loved by the Democrats because she's so critical of Trump. She is nothing more than a war pimp, just like Daddy and just like the 132 neocons who supported, who absolutely now say, yeah, Harris is our woman.
Why? We disagree with her on some things, yeah, but we still think she's better. Look, everybody that we're talking about here that has come out and endorsed her right now, these are the very same people that for many, many years through the Trump administration, we had, you remember the way the old office was, we had these file cabinets,
yes,
filled to the brim, yes, some of them with paper coming out the top,
yes,
filled with attacks on these people, all lists of the horrible things they had done. We spent years, I spent years of my life researching how horrible these, yeah, people are. And if they want me to get excited about Dick Cheney or Liz Cheney, they are kidding themselves. I've been going after Liz Cheney ever since, you know, Democrats started embracing her in 2020 because she hates Trump too. And I said, no, she is not our friend. She does not believe anything we believe in. Stop falling for this charade.
See, that's the difference. The difference, you know why when I get a call, I get an email, we love Farron Cousins. You know why? Because you will step across that aisle and you will call bullshit. And it's bullshit when you have numbnuts within the Democratic organization saying, yeah, these are our pals. This is who we are. We're not the party of war. Just like John Kerry said, we're not the party of war. It started with Bill Clinton, right? Bill Clinton wanted to take the party to the center. He wanted to get all the money from the weapons industry, and it's gotten worse. And then Hillary, hell, she was ready to pull the plug on Russia. She would have started a damn Cold War with Russia had she been elected. Ultimately, she did. But the point is,
she was back at it this week. I don't know if you saw that. I'm going to send you that story.
Absolutely. She can't help herself because the weapons industry have done so much with her for her globalism stand. And we need to get tougher. We need to attack Iran. We need to attack China.
She called for the prosecution this week. I mean, I think it was yesterday, of anyone that uses Russian talking points, as she calls them. And they should be, wow, thrown in jail.
Wow.
So much for freedom of speech there.
So she's nothing more. Just like, unfortunately, the very heart of the Democratic Party have become shills for war.
Yeah.
They've become shills for the weapons industry. And that's not to say the Republicans are any less, But we used to do stories, Farron, if you think about it, where we were only saying this because we could tie up the stories to Republicans. Now, Jesus Christ, I mean, we are the party of war. You had 30 members of the Democratic Party, for example, asking Biden, please negotiate on the Ukraine issue. You remember that? I mean, Bernie Sanders, some of the people that saying, look, let's go negotiate. You know who shattered them down? People like Schumer and Pelosi. People that were running the damn party, running it under the new guise of we are a war machine. We are a war nation. We are war Democrats. And now all those people are wrapping themselves around Harris. There's no way to ignore it.
20 years ago, millions of people took to the streets to protest the Iraq war.
Yeah.
Those are the same people that we talked to, the people that were our audience at the time. And I think they still are. But I don't know that they feel the same anymore. I think they have changed while we're actually sitting here being the same. We have not done anything different, but they forgot who they were 20 years ago when they were marching in the streets with Code Pink and the other groups whose names escape me, unfortunately, with Cindy Sheehan, right?
Yeah, Cindy Sheehan.
Those people were in the streets saying, these folks need to go to jail, and now the Democratic Party.
And now
Party,
they are these folks.
Yeah.
Now this fellow
I'm
right.
I'm not saying Cindy Sheehan is, but well, the party.
Yeah, the party is. Yeah. But this is now a donkey. It used to be an elephant.
Yep.
Thanks for joining me, okay?
Thank you.
That's all the time we have, but all these segments will be posted right here on this channel in the coming weeks, so make sure you subscribe. I'm Mike Papantonio, and this has been America's Lawyer, where we tell you stories every week that corporate media won't tell you because their advertisers don't let them. They can't tell you stories that's going to affect their advertising dollars, or because they're so aligned with a Democratic or Republican party that they've become that. They can't color outside the lines. They can't be objective in their reporting and tell you the other side. We don't have that problem here. If you've just watched this show, you understand that. Hopefully, we'll see you next time.